Hi, my name is Kelly, and I am so excited to introduce you to my favorite tool, the iBloom Planner. This is the tool that I use to manage my life and my business. And today, I am going to walk you through how to begin using this planner to really maximize it so that you can take advantage of all the amazing resources it has. And specifically, we're going to talk about how to plan for a successful month. So one of my favorite things about this planner is there are beautiful tabs. So you just go to the tab and you'll see there's a typical monthly calendar. We'll talk about that in just a moment. But there are also planning pages. This planner is designed to be your personal coach. We all know that we go further and faster when we have a coach asking us the right questions. And that's the focus of this planner. There are two pages that will help you plan for a successful month. So on the second page, you'll see there's a section called What's Going Well. And this is your opportunity to celebrate all the amazing things that are happening in your life. You'll want to think back over the last month or the last few months and really take time to celebrate. I don't know if you're like me, but sometimes it's hard to celebrate because we can just jump to the next thing. But this is your time to really assess what is going well in your life and or your business. The second section is what's not going well. This is your opportunity to get really honest with yourself. A reality check of what are the things in your life that don't seem to be working. It might be something that's creating stress or anxiety or worry or fear. This is your chance to get honest with yourself and to really write down those things that aren't working. And then the third section is what needs to change. Now, generally, these are based on the what's not working. It's the things that we can do something about. So if you notice something is creating a stressor for you, then what is the specific thing that you could change going forward? So many times we wait until the end of the year to do an exercise like this, but this is your opportunity every single month to set your upcoming month up towards success, to make sure you're working toward the goals and priorities that are most important to you. Remember, we get this one life and we want to live it to its fullest. You'll notice that last section there is a notes section. And I personally love to use this for anything I want to remember from that particular month. And so it could be a quote that I read or a book that I want to go back to, something small that I just want to keep kind of at the forefront of my mind. Then going back to the first page, there's monthly goals. Now, these monthly goals will often be for your personal life. It might be your physical health, it might be your finances, it might be relationships, something in your marriage. But also, if you have a business or a ministry or a nonprofit that you're a part of, it would include aspects of that as well. So when we think about our monthly goals, we want to think in terms of what will make this month a success. If I only do these things or I only work toward these things, what would that include? This is going to be a key tool that we use in preparing for each week and each day. Now, I love that this is a blank open space. So those of you who are doodlers or like art journaling, you can make this fun and inspiring for you. Then you'll see there's a gratitude list. Now, I love to use this gratitude list specifically for that month. So we have the big things that we're grateful for, and those tend to land on my list at the top of the list every single time. But for this section, I want to encourage you to think about, okay, specifically this month, what am I most grateful for right now? We know that having a grateful heart is key to accomplishing our goals. It sets our mindset, it sets the tone, it's so valuable. And then there's a section, relationships to invest in. We know we can't be all things to all people. And so you want to make sure you're investing in the relationships that are most important for this particular month. It might be somebody visiting you, or you're traveling somewhere, or somebody has a birthday. These are going to be the key relationships that you're going to invest in. And I like to write specifically, how am I going to invest in that relationship? So I might put my husband on there. What am I specifically going to do this month to invest in our marriage? You can use this however you want, though. It's your tool to maximize to its benefit. And then you'll notice at the end of each monthly page, there's an inspirational quote. And I love this one, so I'll share it with you today. It's, "Get ready, because God is going to do more than you could ask or imagine this year. Trust Him and His perfect timing." Then we have the monthly page. This is your typical monthly calendar. This is the place where I like to write big picture things. So it might be somebody's birthday, or if I'm traveling out of town, a big event. You do not want to use this section to write all of your appointments, all the little nitty gritty things. You will have plenty of space for that in the weekly and daily pages that we'll talk about in upcoming videos. But this monthly page, it's meant to be a big picture snapshot. And you'll see there are a couple of other tools. One would be the monthly focus. What's the most important thing this month? You might even write a particular theme that you want to focus on this month, or a character quality that you want to cultivate this month, and you're gonna be intentional about that. And then I love this note section. Again, you could use it for quotes that you want to remember, specific things from the month that are kind of top of mind. Some people also will use this for tracking financial things. If you have bills that are due, you could put that in that section as well. Again, this is your tool. And the idea with these videos is to teach you how to maximize it so that you can make the most of the iBloom Planner. Thank you for joining me. I am so grateful that you have learned how to plan for a successful month. I'll see you in some upcoming videos as I teach you how to plan for a successful week, how to plan for a successful day, and then my favorite, how to plan for a successful year so that you're tying all of it together and living a life of purpose and fulfillment.